Hello there, welcome back. Let's talk about network topology. So for any communication, we require a sender, a receiver, transmission medium such as copper cable, data or message, and the protocol itself. Yeah. So there are a few types of communication, such as simplex mode, which means the data flow is only one way. Then we have half duplex, which means that data can only flow either way, but not simultaneously. Or full duplex, which is simultaneous both ways data flow. So nowadays, in general, most of the communication will be full duplex, whereby it can actually flow in both ways. So when a message is sent, it can be unicast, which means one-to-one communication, or one-to-all, or multicast, which means one-to-many, or many-to-many, yeah. So let's look at different type of network topology. First of all, we have bus, we have star, we have mesh, and we have hybrid network topology, yeah. So let's look at bus topology. So if you look at the figure on the right, this is actually bus topology. So let's start with the use case. So it's actually used in small company or office environment. And what are the benefits of bus topology? First of all, it means that if one of the nodes fail, the remainder of network can continue to function. So for example, if you look at this, if this node fail, the other nodes can actually still function. The next is, it's easy to increase the size of network by just adding additional nodes. So it's actually quite easy to just add more nodes on this bus network itself. Then what are the drawbacks of bus topology? First of all, if the main cable fails, the whole network will just go down. So for example, you look at this black line here. It means that if the cable fails, it means that all the nodes will just stop functioning because they are all connected to the same cable. Next is the performance is not good under heavy loading due to collision. So if you look at this, the message will be sent through this wire. So there will be a lot of collision happening in bus topology. So the next is actually not as secure since each packet passes through every node. It means that for example, the messages will actually send to every single node until it actually reached the right node. Yeah. So let's look at star topology. So if you look at the figure on the right, it's actually a star topology, whereby it actually looks like a star. So what is the use case of star topology? First of all, it's actually used for application with heavy data traffic. Next, let's talk about central node, which means this central node of the star topology. The central node can either be hub, which means that it actually sent to all the nodes regardless of recipients, or can act as a switch, which means that it actually sent to the right recipient. For example, let's say this node wants to send message to this node. If it's a hub, it means that when it sends a message to the central node, it actually will broadcast to all the every single nodes until it actually reach the right node. This is like a hub representation. For switch, let's say this A tried to send to B, so when it's actually sent to the central node, it's actually just from A to B without sending to other nodes. Yeah. So these are differences between hub and switch at the central node. Yeah. So let's look at the benefits of star topology. Yeah. First of all, the data collisions are actually greatly reduced, especially if the central node actually acts as a switch. The next is actually more secure since security can be applied at the central node, which means a packet will only travel to the right address, you know, for the switch use case. The next will be if one of the connection is broken, actually only affect one of the nodes. For example, you know, the connection is broken, the other nodes, they can still function as usual. The drawbacks of star topologies are the initial installation costs are high. Next is if the central node, which is this node here, fails, the whole network will just go down because they actually communicate through the central node. So it means that if this goes down, you know, all the connection will just go down here. So let's look at mesh topology. Yeah. So if you look at the figure on the right, this is actually the representation of mesh topology. All the nodes are actually connected to each other. So what are the use case of mesh topology? Actually used in the internet or the WAN, which is the wide area network. Then we actually use for monitoring and control systems such as medical monitoring of patients in the hospital or for electronics interconnectivity such as the internet of things, you know, the smart home. Everything actually use a mesh topology. So what are the benefits of a mesh topology? First of all, it's actually easy to identify when a fault occurs. Is there any broken links on the network do not affect other nodes? For example, if the connection between this and this is broken, you actually do not actually affect other nodes. Next is network is actually relatively easy to expand and actually offers good privacy or security since each packet actually travels through dedicated routes. So what are drawbacks of mesh topology? First of all, it's actually expensive and time consuming due to large amount of cabling. So if you look at this mesh topology itself, you can see that it's actually quite complex to connect like every node to every single node within the network itself. The next is the setup and maintenance actually quite difficult and complex to actually maintain this mesh topology. Yeah. Lastly, let's look at hybrid topology. So if you look at this diagram here, this is actually a mixture of a bus topology and star topology. Yeah. What are the benefits of this hybrid topology? First of all, it's actually able to handle large volume of traffic. It's actually easy to identify where network fault occurs depending on how the hybrid topology is being designed. And what are the drawbacks of this hybrid topology? The biggest drawback is that it's actually very complex to install, configure and maintain, because you have to actually mix different type of topology into one topology. Yeah. So in general, it's actually quite complex to actually do the installation and configuration. Yeah. So we have covered different type of network topology in this video. We have covered bus topology, star topology, mesh topology, and hybrid topology, which is the mixture of any of these topology. Definitely, if you're interested to learn more about computer science, feel free to subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you in a future video. Yeah. Bye bye.